into the chairs of our lives. Even when they become empty, traces of the person remain. There is an ache, realizing the chair is empty. But there's also a joy, knowing that all we have loved in our life remains soaked with our spirit. Even that chair that appears so empty.
Christmas this year, for many of us, will have a different resonance. As the familiar signs and sounds of Christmas assail our senses and the spirit of the season gathers momentum, we may struggle to embrace this traditional season of festivity and celebration, because without the ones we have loved this Christmas, there is an empty chair.
And so this empty chair at Christmas Remembrance Concert, presented by Tobin Brothers Funerals, is a time for us to gather together in the spirit of Christmas and to remember a father, a mother, a husband, a wife, a son or a daughter, a grandson or a granddaughter, a brother, a sister, a nephew or a niece, a partner, a companion, or one of our very close friends.
This evening's concert, ladies and gentlemen, began with a Christmas carol that dates back 250 years. And we also heard the unmistakable, deep, throaty thrum of the didgeridoo, the instrument so inextricably linked to Australia's Indigenous people. I don't know if you know this, but in many Aboriginal communities, Christmas has become a very important time to remember those who have died, and in honouring their memories, we wish also to acknowledge the traditional custodians of the land on which we meet tonight.
This evening's concert is a celebration of music in some of its many forms, and indeed it's also a celebration of the many talented singers and instrumentalists who have helped us to make this event so possible. The Australian Children's Choir, the Eltham High School Band, Symphonic Band, Aldous Tria, Robbie Belchamber, and Angus Radley from VCAS, and entertainer and media personality, Denis Walter.
During this concert, ladies and gentlemen, the names of some of those people being remembered will appear on the screen. There will be others whose names you may not see, but whose memories nonetheless still burn brightly in the hearts of those who love them. And tonight we honour them all. We also welcome to this concert those who are viewing this very special event via the Tobin Brothers Funerals website. Whether you're online in New Zealand, in Australia, or in some other part of the world, we also welcome you.
One of Australia's finest musical exports is the Australian Children's Choir, which is based right here in Melbourne. There are approximately 200 singers in the choir in all, and their ages range from 7 right through to 18. Not only do they perform regularly throughout Australia, but they have become the most fantastic ambassadors for this country overseas. They've toured in England and Hong Kong, Wales, New Zealand, and mainland China, and their lovely voices have been heard in Vienna, in Salzburg, in Prague, in Edinburgh, Cambridge, and London. And they have performed with the Melbourne Symphony Orchestra, the Royal Melbourne Philharmonic, the Royal Australian Naval Band, and the Victoria Police Show Band.
Melissa, there's something strangely reassuring about children's voices in song. Their innocence and the joy remind us of the continuance of life, don't they? They lift our spirits and they give us hope. And so you can imagine just how delighted we were when 38 members of this wonderful choir agreed to sing at tonight's concert.
This evening, the choir, accompanied by Amir Farid, is conducted by the ACC's Artistic Director, Andrew Wales. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, please make very welcome the Australian Children's Choir to sing to us the bells of Christmas.
ladies and gentlemen, please thank the Australian Children's Choir. Beautiful. During that performance of Bells of Christmas, you perhaps recognised on the screen the names of someone that you loved and you still love, and whose memory will never, ever die. And thank heaven for our memories. They are really one of life's greatest pleasures. They're a link with the past and a lasting legacy for the future. And whilst this Christmas may certainly be filled with a degree of pain, loneliness and isolation, perhaps, just perhaps, it can also be a time to wander through those memories.
Yes, it can. Memories are wonderful things for us. And it's not to deny that this Christmas is so different from Christmases past. And it's not to pretend that nothing has changed, but rather to draw strength from all that your loved ones meant to you. And to remember, perhaps with some gratitude, perhaps with some joy, or even at times laughter, the many other Christmas times you spent together. I remember quite vividly that Christmas in our house always meant the beginning of summer holidays at Phillip Island. There were long days at the beach in the caravan and out in the boat skiing and swimming. But Christmas Day was still traditional, a roast lunch, Mum's strawberry pavlova, which continues to this day. But for my dad, he was always keen to get going, and there was always a sense of urgency and anticipation for Boxing Day morning, when he would be up, dressed, impatient and ready to go. My dad passed away a number of years ago now, but we still miss him greatly, and we miss him particularly at Christmas. Mike, what are your memories of Christmas?
Well, my memories of Christmas, well, I guess my most enduring memory will be of my mum's absolute determination that regardless of the fact that she was the mother of eight children and there wasn't a whole lot of money to go around, that each Christmas be as happy and as joyous as she could possibly make it. As kids, we'd help her decorate the lounge room and the Christmas tree, which she insisted had to be a real one. And my sister reminded me just the other day that Christmas Day itself was not complete without her mouth-watering coconut ice and fruit mince tarts, which she made every single Christmas Eve. My mum died in the second week of December last year, and although obviously I miss her a great deal, I'm so glad, so very glad to have so many, many memories with which to fill her empty chair.
Here in Melbourne, as in many other cities around the world, one of the things we associate with the festive season is the good old Salvation Army Band as they play their carols outside our shopping centres at Christmas time. But here on stage tonight, seated right in front of you, we actually have members of the Eltham High School Symphonic Band, and it's one of the most senior band, or it is the most senior band at the school. Over many years, the band has earned a very enviable reputation for musical excellence, not only within Victoria, but interstate and overseas as well. They've had a very memorable and full calendar of performances this past year, which culminated when they won the ABODA South Australia Advanced Concerts Band section of the Royal South Street Estedford in the Premier Wind Ensemble section. Phew, that was a mouthful. So ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together tonight for the Eltham High School Symphonic Band, which is conducted by the school's Director of Music, Mr. Rick Plummer.
Thank you.
Well-deserved applause for the Eltham High School Symphonic Band with a work known as Luxurumke, written by Eric Whiteacre. Luxurumke, or Light and Gold, began its life as an a cappella choral work and was used by the composer for his virtual choir project. His debut album, Light and Gold, released in October 2010, became the number one classical album in US and UK charts within just a week. The piece, full of light, glowing harmonies, is based on the Latin translation of an English poem by Edward Esche, who wrote this: "Light, warm and heavy as pure gold, and angels sing softly to the newborn babe."
And I hope their beautiful, soulful music transported you to many places in your memories. One of the loveliest aspects, I think, of this time of year is its ability to lift us out of the ordinary. It's a time of year that's marked as special and significant, and we all have our rituals and our patterns which we've followed from year to year. Those favourite things that we love to do, which mark this time of festival and family and celebration, which are unique to our family and to our own lives. Of course, for some people, the night before Christmas, Christmas Eve, might mean singing along at home with Denis Walter and Marina Pryor at carols by candlelight, or attending midnight mass at your local church. For others, it brings the excitement of watching those gorgeous little faces on the children as they open their presents under the Christmas tree, of preparing the Christmas Day family barbecue, of cooking the turkey, the ham, the prawns, or the lobster, or whatever your family does, and looking for those elusive coins in the brandy-soaked Christmas pudding.
At Christmas this year, you may be finding it difficult or even painful to even consider participating in so many of those aspects of Christmas that you've enjoyed and relished in the past. Maybe you just don't have the energy. Maybe this year you need to be a little gentler on yourself. Give yourself permission to do things a little differently this year, to invest in Christmas in new ways.
And perhaps you just like to take yourself right away, to have some quiet time by yourself on your own, to perhaps visit the cemetery, or to go to a special place of remembering, as you all have in coming here tonight. You may also like to create some new rituals which express this time of year for you in a different way. Or you may just decide to go to the cupboard and take out those favourite ornaments, take them out of the box, put up the Christmas tree and decorate it with those ornaments. Yeah, maybe accompanied by a tear or two. Perhaps to pick a favourite photo and place a candle of remembrance beside it. Write a letter to the one you have loved, or bring them to the Christmas table in the many stories and recollections that you tell. Or maybe you might draw comfort in the playing of some of their favourite music.
Yes, well, of course, music is a wonderful vehicle for the expression of emotion. In fact, I think it was the French novelist Victor Hugo who said, "Music expresses that which cannot be put into words, and that which cannot remain silent."
And while that's true, there is absolutely no way that the Australian Children's Choir is able to remain silent for very long these days. Throughout any given year, they're kept very busy learning and rehearsing new material for their performances, which are going to take them all over the country. And we are truly delighted to have them with us tonight. And under the direction of Andrew Wales, and accompanied again by Farida Mia, they are now going to sing for us Christmas Lullaby. I'd love to be able to sing like that, Michael.
Absolutely.
Ladies and gentlemen, please thank the Australian Children's Choir once again.
I think some of us this afternoon during rehearsal were absolutely gobsmacked when we walked into the auditorium and heard these beautiful voices. Somebody said they were just like angels. Every day of the year, ladies and gentlemen, we at Tobin Brothers Funeral is a privilege to care for and to assist many families celebrate the lives of their loved ones. Tonight, we're delighted through their performances at this concert to be able to celebrate the talents of some very fine singers and musicians, three of whom are from the Victorian College of the Arts Secondary School.
Back in August of this year, Michael Sargent, the school's director of music, enthusiastically accepted our invitation to have the winner of this year's VCAS John Hopkins Award perform at this concert tonight. Sadly, a month later, Mr. Hopkins, who was 86, passed away.
And as an indication as to the extent to which both the man and his music will be missed, you have only to read the plethora of Facebook tributes to him. In one of these, the author says this: John Hopkins, a truly iconic figure in Australian music. Thank you for your inspirations and your guidance. And from a VCAS student, thank you for showing us all the humanity and the humility of music. What powerful sentiments, Melissa.
Yes, they certainly are. But then, John Hopkins was widely regarded as a giant in Australian classical music. He was made an officer of the British Empire, an OBE, in 1970, and earlier this year he was awarded the Order of Australia. John Hopkins was born in Britain, and he became one of the youngest ever conductors of a BBC orchestra.
Yes, and here in Australia, he was the former federal director of music for the ABC. He founded the Darwin Symphony Orchestra, and he went on to become the very first dean of music at the Victorian College of the Arts. And it's in his honour that the John Hopkins Award is presented annually to the VCAS music student recognised as the most outstanding of any given year.
This year, that award has been presented to guitarist Aldous Tria. And I asked Aldous when we were talking outside whether he thought he had a chance of winning this award, and he said no, he had no idea at all. Aldous was born in the Philippines and he moved with his family to Australia about 4 years ago.
He tells us also that he first picked up a guitar when he was just 10 years old, and that his father, also a guitarist, was probably his biggest influence. Aldous began by playing rock music but gravitated to jazz about 2 years ago. He auditioned twice for VCAS and was finally accepted at year 11 in 2012. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, please give a very big welcome to the winner of the 2013 John Hopkins Award, Aldous Tria.
Thank you.
Students, Robbie Belchamber on guitar and Angus, Radley on bass, a piece entitled Made in France.
Thank you.
What a stunning performance, and how exciting to have musicians like that in our midst here in Melbourne, ladies and gentlemen. Give them a big hand. Aldous Tria, Robbie Belchamber, and Angus.
You took the words right out of my mouth.
In presenting this empty chair at Christmas Remembrance Concert, ladies and gentlemen, we are reminded that grief can be such a lonely and isolating journey. For in truth, who we love and how we love is such a unique and personal experience. And yet, you know, the company of family and friends, the sharing of feelings and stories can be so immensely comforting and reassuring, even though you may feel like crossing Christmas off the calendar this year.
The process of grief is so complex. In the midst of great sadness, we can also experience feelings of happiness and of laughter. And yet, enjoying those moments of happiness does not mean that you've stopped loving or missing the person that you have lost. And nor, of course, does it mean that you must deal with your grief alone. Support is available through a number of organisations who are able to put you in touch with professionals, grief counsellors, who are able to provide a steady and an understanding voice. Whatever your choice, it is in the sharing of your loss, as in coming here tonight to this concert of remembrance, that you will find much support.
You certainly will. And now, ladies and gentlemen, the Eltham High School Symphonic Band is going to present a work that has a very poignant relevance to the theme of tonight's concert, that of loss, celebration, and the reaffirmation of life. What the band is about to play was actually composed in memory of Lynn Jones, a baritone saxophone player with the Cedar Rapids High School Band of Ohio. Lynn Jones, who was tragically killed in a motor accident, wrote a poem just days before his death entitled I Am. You'll see the words on the screen. It was a poem that inspired the piece the Eltham School Symphonic Band will play for us now. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
What talented kids you all are. Fantastic. It was a great performance, wasn't it, from the Eltham High School Symphonic Band. Whilst many people find Christmas a difficult time emotionally, others find this festive season a real struggle financially. And so in promoting this Empty Chair at Christmas Remembrance Concert, we invited those of you attending tonight to bring with you a small gift. And of course those gifts are going to be distributed to Melbourne's less fortunate through the Salvation Army.
And the response to that invitation has been extremely heartwarming, ladies and gentlemen. We do thank you for your compassion and your generosity. And we'd now like to introduce Dr. Bruce Redman, the Media Relations Spokesperson for the Salvation Army. Thank you.
It's my great pleasure to be here tonight representing the Salvation Army. The thing I love about Tobin Brothers is that they share something very in common with the Salvation Army, and that is dignity. They're all about dignity, and that's the way that we look at the people that that we deal with. And when I look at all those names on the screen who mean something to everyone here, I'm reminded that they loved and that they were loved. They were part of a community, and that's the way that we look at people that we deal with within the Salvation Army. It may be someone who's sleeping in a park, or someone who's struggling with drug and alcohol problems, or a mum who's just finding it really, really hard to make ends meet. But what we try and do is to give them that sense of dignity. And by you being here tonight and by bringing a gift for them, that is a really wonderful thing, and we really appreciate it very much. Salvation Army will help about 300,000 people in just this month around Australia. We, on Christmas Day, will provide about 8,000 meals for people who've got nowhere else to go. And on that day, they'll have a sense of community, they'll have a sense of family, they'll have a sense that they mean something, they'll have memories, like we all will, of loved ones, family that they've lost, family that they're separated from. But at that time, they will feel a sense of they are somebody and that they can enjoy Christmas just like you and I. So the gifts that you've given tonight will be distributed by Salvation Army Community Support Centres and will be a real source of joy and hope for people out there this Christmas. My wife and I have been on the distribution team of presents in the past, and we've been to some areas where some families are doing it really tough, and seen the faces on some of these kids when out of the back of the car we pull out something that they could never imagine that Santa would be bringing them this year. And what you've provided today is very, very much appreciated. So tonight, on behalf of the Salvation Army, I just want to say thank you. The Salvos only do our work because of the generosity of Australians and people like yourselves. I'd like to just say God bless you this time of the year as you remember your loved ones, and we really appreciate that you've remembered some other people who are out there in the world as well. Thanks very much.
Thank you very much, Dr. Bruce Redman, and for all the work that the Salvation Army do. They are so well recognised within our community. And now, ladies and gentlemen, let's once again listen to the Australian Children's Choir as they sing firstly that beautiful carol, Silent Night, and then followed by Personant Hodie. Thank you.
Thank you.
final contribution to our concert, ladies and gentlemen, is the 38 members of the magnificent Australian Children's Choir. And their bags are packed, aren't they? They're headed to China, to mainland China.
For 8 days
on Boxing Day. So quick Christmas, pack the bags and off to the airport. But they're fantastic. Their music is just beautiful.
Give them a final round of applause. And also to their masterful conductor, Andrew Williams. Well, after 40 years on the Australian entertainment scene, he remains one of this country's most successful performers. The host of 3AW's top rating afternoon program and the recipient of Gold Records, he's given command performances, appeared in countless television guest spots, and he's become an absolute institution at Carols by Candlelight at the Meyer Music Bar. Ladies and gentlemen, please give a very warm welcome to the one and only Denis Walter.
I would have to say you're part of the rituals in our house on Christmas Eve as we sit watching carols by candlelight. We're a stay-at-home family by the tally in the warm.
That's fair enough.
And we're usually wrapping the last of our presents frantically.
Have you wrapped mine yet? No, not yet.
No, not yet, but I will. And I can remember quite clearly the year that you sang with your dad. It was really, really, really lovely.
1990. Well, I think lots of people remember that particular
one. Yeah, it was
one.
A really special moment. What was Christmas like in your house? What do you remember? Who do you miss at Christmas?
Obviously parents-in-law. And it's my 30th Carol by Candlelight this year, so that sort of dominated that. Thank you. It's dominated Christmases for so long. I missed one year and I thought, oh, they're never going to ring me again, but they rang the next year and I've been on ever since. But some very special memories, some of them really, some that are very, very amusing to us as a family. My wife's and its mother, late mother, she used to, on different years, go to different children's houses and cook up a storm. But our house was on two separate electricity systems, I don't know why. But she arrived with sunbeam skillets, sunbeam fry pans, and we had this line of the old-style cooking, which shorted out about 15 times during the day, and I had to go to the garage every time to get the power back on. But wonderful memories, terrific memories.
Wonderful memories. And so if you've had 30 years at Carols by Candlelight, that makes you how old?
How old? Very.
Yes, that's what I thought.
Very.
It's an interesting thing, though, isn't it? Loss is universal to us all as human beings, and none of us escape its touch, not at all. Why don't you sing for us again?
I'd love to. This is a beautiful Christmas song. It came to my attention about 5 years ago, and I recorded it on a Christmas album, and it's got a lovely feel about it, and I hope you enjoy it. Christmas is a time, Christmas is a time, it's a time for love. Christmas is a time, Christmas is a time, it's a time for love. We often start to worry and people get upset when things don't go all right on Christmas Day. What we should remember in all the push and shove, Christmas is a time for love. Christmas is a time, Christmas is a time, it's a time for love. Christmas is a time, Christmas is a time, it's a time for love. Maybe things don't sound right or look the way they should, and maybe they're not perfectly in tune. What we should remember is the need to rise above. Christmas is a time for love. Christmas is a time, Christmas is a time, it's a time for love. Christmas is a time, Christmas is a time, it's a time for love. Christmas is a time, Christmas is a time, it's a time for love. Christmas is a time, Christmas is a time, it's a time for love. Merry Christmas, everybody.
Ladies and gentlemen, Denis Walter. Denis Walter, who, of course, next Tuesday night will once again join a star-studded cast on Channel 9's Carols by Candlelight. Thank you, Denis.
Ladies and gentlemen, we'd like to introduce the chairman of Tobin Brothers Funerals to you, Mr. Michael Tobin.
Ladies and gentlemen, please thank Denis Walter, who next Thursday night will once again join us cast on Channel 9's Carols by Candlelight. And ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, tonight through words, music and memories, we hope you have been assisted to remember the many happy years with those whose departure from this world has sadly left you with an empty chair. This evening, you have not only celebrated through your memories the lives of those who cannot be with you at Christmas, but by being here, you have also helped celebrate the very fine musicianship of more than 100 very talented young people. So perhaps we'll just acknowledge that one for now. This empty chair at Christmas Remembrance Concert would not have been possible without the wholehearted support of Elise Weisbrook, Andrew Stratton and the events team here at Federation Square. We must also thank Rick Plummer and the Eltham High School Symphonic Band, Andrew Wales and the Australian Children's Choir, Aldous Tria, Robbie Belchamber, and Angus Radley from the Victorian College of the Arts Secondary School, the Salvation Army, and of course, Denis Walter. Thanks also go to my colleagues from Tobin Brothers who have assisted this evening in comparing and emceeing the concert, Michael Lynch and Melissa Laird. And I would especially like to thank all of you, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, not only for supporting this very special event, but also for the gifts you have placed under the tree for Melbourne's less fortunate families. In return, as you leave this venue tonight, I would like each of you to accept on our behalf a very special remembrance candle for your empty tree at Christmas. Thank you.
Thank you, Michael, very much. It is never easy to cope with the loss of someone we love, never. The changes in our life which grief imposes take time and perseverance to adapt to. We all know that as human beings, our life here on earth has a limited time span to it. And yet, that knowing does not diminish our intense sense of loss when faced with the death of someone that we love. This year, of course, you'll be reminded again that Christmas will never be the same. But the truth is, neither will you. But while the loss of someone that you have loved deeply certainly changes us profoundly, it doesn't have to change us for the worst. It can offer us the opportunity to refine our sense of what is important in our lives, to change what needs to be changed, to hold strong to what we believe, and to go forward with a renewed sense of purpose.
Although the image of the empty chair so eloquently symbolises the loneliness of loss, The words of Pamela McCauley, spoken by Melissa at the beginning of this concert, ladies and gentlemen, encourages us to look beyond the immediate and remember that the legacy of the person that we have loved and lost remains deep within us. And so as you leave here tonight, may you find comfort and consolation in the recollections of Christmas's past. May the empty chair in your life be filled with a wealth of wonderful memories. And may the spirit of Christmas and those you have lost live long in your hearts.
Thank you.